me and Jamie met. We met on in Willesden Green Tube Station, didn't we?
Yeah.
And you were like stroking an animal at the time. I think, was it a small leopard?
It was a dog, actually.
It was a dog. That was it. It looked a bit like a leopard. And no, we met in a studio, and we were intrinsically drawn to each other, and
Tommy's range of shirts that I'm drawn to,
and his range of quality knitwear. I love his range. I love doing this. Ooh. We hooked up to a writing session, and the track we came up with was Staring to the Sun, and it was such an obviously wicked tune that was completely nothing to do with Jamie's
my last record,
solo record.
And they had an idea of trying to strip it onto my last album, and I was just like...
We went, no!
So in answer to your question, that's how we met. I think that the sound of GRAFFITI6, there was nothing conscious about it in terms of thought about. It was just something that happened when we worked together.
It comes from his voice, though. I'll say this now. The sound of GRAFFITI6 definitely comes from Jamie's voice. Because everything that, you know, and that's how it should be with music. A voice should determine what it's going on. The music is the frame around the picture, and the voice is the picture. And it's so the voice is where it came from. And as soon as he started singing the way that he was doing, and as soon as I started messing up his vocals the way I've been doing, that was it. The rest of it was obvious. It was like all the drum sounds, the guitars, everything. But I think as we've progressed, we started to find specific things that we know. Both me and Jamie know our GRAFFITI6 like.
And I think that we have a way of recording, like, kind of. I mean, the whole record is just the two of us in this room playing, you know, everything between us. And I think that we kind of have a way now of recording, don't we? Like when we have an idea, we kind of know what each other does, and it's kind of there's a method.
It's a lot of tea. It's a lot of tea involved.
Herbal
tea. The Sun thing came about because we bought loads and loads of copies of The Sun, and we made this huge 40-foot paper mache head out of Sun copies, which we made and stuck outside, 40-foot head of Jamie, and we just stuck it outside of News International until eventually they took notice of us.
Did I give the real story?
No, that is the real story. You don't know what we went through to get that bloody thing.
Tommy's publisher heard the track randomly last year.
Now, so, James Murdoch, the son of Richard Branson, he picked it particularly. I don't know whether that was particularly a good thing or not, but it's nice to know that someone personally liked the track. The Sun have never used a track like that. They've never used a thing that's not been signed or not had any kind of push behind it or whatever. It caught us a bit by surprise as well, because we were sort of encased in this room here in Northwest London making music, and we hadn't really thought about actually releasing it or letting anyone else hear it. So it was good. What it did do was it kind of made us realise that we ought to get our asses in gear and get this stuff out there, because everyone was loving it. So. Question and a half, isn't it?
Well, looking around the room, I think there's quite a Hendrix-y...
My inspiration is the traditional ones. It's Hendrix, the Beatles, particularly the Beatles. But also all kinds of stuff. I think you're mad to shut anything off. I always use the analogy that if you're a painter, you wouldn't say, I like orange but I don't like blue, or I don't ever paint with green.
I grew up on a lot of folk music, so I kind of was into Bob Dylan, Joni Mitchell, Carole King. I kind of grew up on that, and then I think as I grew older I kind of started getting into things like Buckley. And then I think that, you know, the one thing when I came here, the one person that you're into that I remember thinking this is going to work was that you're a Lewis Taylor fan.
Yeah.
And I was a bit, I've worked with Lewis and I'm quite a big Lewis Taylor fan. And
there's a lot of different influences in GRAFFITI6's music. I'm always a big fan of beats. And a big fan of making things have to groove, they have to feel really, really good. You can have a great song with a shit groove, you can have a great groove with a shit song, but if you've got a great groove and a great song, you want something.
I'm Jamie Scott.
I'm Jamie Scott. You're Jamie Scott.
I'm Jamie Scott. You
I'm
are.
I'm Tommy D.
And we are...
GRAFFITI6.